What is the difference between practicing what you like and what you need? Difference you can see in the result. Because if you keep practicing what you like, you will not progress. That doesn't upgrade your level of playing. And also because you don't know really the difference between practice and playing. This is one of the essential things. Playing is when you play stuff there, you play things that you like to play or anything, but practicing means that you are practicing stuff that you don't have, still master, or don't have control over it yet. Because when you do that properly, then you become stronger playing. So otherwise, you would, because most people, only if they ever practice, which there are very few, 90% of them now can only keep playing, and then they keep guessing, why I would be stuck? I have 15 years playing and I'm still the same level of Picado. Why? Because first of all, they don't follow a method. They don't have a teacher. They do alone. And I said, do it yourself and be confused forever. Good luck with that. In flamenco doesn't work. I don't know if in rocks it works or in other things, but here, for sure, I never seen anyone doing any of that. It's been that way. So you need to have a guidance. And that's what we do in the coaching program. In the sky. But anyway, the thing is that you need to understand how to practice so that you can upgrade the level. And then therefore, there's what the teacher has a job to do, because we as students, we like certain things and we don't like other materials. But that's what you don't like. If you need that, then good luck, because you are not doing it, and that's why you're stuck. So and therefore, this is also the difference between intermediate beginners and advanced students. Advanced student practices 90% of the time things that they need, not what they like. Beginners, opposite, 90% what they like and 10% or less what they need. And intermediate students or players, they go 50-50, playing half and then, yeah, practicing things which they need other half of their time. So you need to, that's why you need to observe yourself, what you do exactly. And for that, you need a teacher, because this is the best way. That way you will save time. This is the thing. So then therefore, if you keep only doing what you like, you never go up in playing music. So the solution is to first understand what I'm saying and why I'm saying what I'm saying. And then if you decide to join the study program and to your capacity from the scratch on any level, go for it. I make sure that you go up. Because we practice what you need. You don't know what you need actually. This is why people cannot do alone these things. Because you don't know even exactly what you need and how to get out of this stuck point that you are now at present. Because most people have years playing. If you analyze how many years have happened with you having same level of rhythm or technique or arpeggios or scales, etc., people is stuck forever. It takes years. They say, my God, if I realized this 10 years ago, man, I will be... Now it would be back with Lucia 3 again, because you misuse the time. So saving time, very important. Because how do you save time? By knowing how. How is about you, how to do things. Of course, on the internet there are 20 million videos with a bunch of material out there, but they don't tell you what, they don't tell you how you will do it. They only said what to do, if that is even there. Sometimes not even that is there. But what is not the subject, the point? The point is how you will do it. And to personalize that information and go against this prison of the mind that you don't like to do something, but you need it. We maybe don't like scales, but we need that. Or we can also start to say, well, playing picado is not the only norm. Translation, I have very bad picado. So just analyze this thing, because this is actually what they mean, what they meant. Okay, thank you, and I see you next time.
Muy bien, Pablo.
Sí, Paco, ¿qué es para usted la música popular y qué es la música elitista?
Yo creo que la música elitista es el refinamiento de la música popular. Por ejemplo, el flamenco. El flamenco originalmente es una música popular, la música del pueblo de Andalucía. Pero creo que ya no le pertenece más al pueblo, porque de pronto habemos gente que nos hemos pasado toda una vida encerrado puliendo esa expresión popular. Entonces ha llegado a un nivel en el que el pueblo ya no tiene acceso, sobre todo a los matices que vamos consiguiendo la gente como yo, que nos pasamos muchas horas elaborando esa música.
En el libro que descubrí ahí, la improvisación. La improvisación es algo que yo pienso que cada músico debería, a músico del estilo que sea, del clásico, del flamenco, de cualquier otra música, debería aprender, porque la improvisación te da mucha libertad y a la vez te da mucho conocimiento de dónde estás tocando y cómo estás tocando, de qué armonías están en cada momento, ¿no?